วัสดีครับ We meet as usual in this Thailand at Large program. And today, I have brought our viewers to Ubon Ratchathani province. This is one of the provinces that is located on a plain area rich with various resources. There are several rivers that run and join each other, making the place a suitable location for inhabitants in the past. Equally important is the fact that there was an unearthing of evidence of civilization living here during antiquity time no less than 10,000 years ago. From a community of animal hunters, it has evolved to become an agriculture community during the past 2 to 3,000 years ago. I will now bring our unseen Thailand viewers to visit this beautiful way of life of locals in Ubon Ratchathani. From the city of Ubon Ratchathani province, we use route 217 and continue to Amphoe Phibun Mangsahan and then use route 2222 until we reach Amphoe Khong Chiem. This is very convenient. And the first activity that you shouldn't miss when you come to Ubon Ratchathani is to see the sunrise. If you open the map and you look at the location of Ubon Ratchathani on the map, you can see that it is located on the northeasternmost of Thailand. So that's why we always hear the promotion of this province to say that this is the best spot for us to see the sunrise. And here I am at Patam National Park. This is one of the first locations to see sunrise in Thailand. As I have mentioned, this is another place in the country where we can witness the first sunrise. This is because in Ubon Ratchathani province, there are three locations where we can visit to have a first glance at sunrise before others. These are Patam National Park, Phachanadai, and the last location is Ban Pak La. Actually, if we were to bring up the map and spread it out, we would see that Ban Pak La is in Amphoe Khong Chiem, which has a coordinate and geographical location situated in the furthest east region of the country. However, at Ban Pak La, there are high mountains from Laos that blind the curves. This is a significant obstruction for us in viewing the sunrise. As for Phachanadai, the meteorological department uses its location to calculate the sunrise time in the morning. Traveling to this place is very difficult. Therefore, the most convenient location to see the sunrise is at this Patam National Park. And as earlier informed, we are now within the Patam National Park. Besides from having a chance to view the first sunrise in the country, this the first national park in the country to have Mekong River run through its territory and serve as a demarcation point between Thailand and Laos. It is also the longest demarcating instrument of any national park. Standing from this point, we can see the landscape view in Laos territory. This site on this bank of river in Thailand size, here we also rich in term of natural. We can see a lot of forest, a lot of trees, and there are a lot of animals in this area also. Patam is a name coined by locals since ancient times. The word pa means cliff, and tam means to put in color, or in other words, to draw it in. The most important part and uniqueness of this Patam is its accumulation of ancient evidence.
which is the discovery of ancient color drawings before antiquity that dates back to 3,000 to 4,000 years. I think this Patam is becoming more interesting, and I have made an appointment with Pipai that will lead us through the history of Ubon Rajthani in better details.
So right now we are at the first spot that he said that we should stop and see. เราก็มาถึงจุดแรกที่พี่บอกให้ผมหยุดดูแล้วทีนี้ผมยังไม่รู้เลยตรงนี้ให้หยุดดูแล้วมีอะไรบ้าง I have no idea else. Like we have to stop here, but then what happened? I don't see anything yet. ผมยังไม่เห็นอะไรเลยเนี่ยฮะ
ตรงนี้เรียกว่าจุดผาขาม
ผาขาม
ผาขามคือภาพสลัก
อ๋อข้างบนนู้นเลยนะฮะ
ที่เป็นร่องรอย
ครับ
ก็จะเป็นร่องรอยคล้ายปลาคล้ายใบไม้อันนี้เป็นภาพที่เหมือนการขูดการขีด
ครับ
จะไม่ใช่เหมือนลักษณะการวาดซึ่งอันนี้จะเป็นยุคแรกของกลุ่มชุดภาพสีที่ปรากฏอยู่ในผาแต้ม
อ๋อโอเค so this first spot we call it ผาขามผาขาม is the name of this place and what we have here is the you know the painting over there we actually don't really call it a painting becauseHe's mentioned that this is from the prehistoric era where we didn't do painting but we instead do like carving like scratch on the stone surface in order to create a kind of picture and it is look it looks similar to the shape of the fish or can be feather or can be leaf so the shape will be like yeah like this ครับนี่ก็เป็นรูปทรงนี้แล้วใช่มั้ยฮะ
ใช่ครับซึ่งแต่ก่อนคนมันจะรูปไงไอ้ตรงนี้ไอ้ตรงนี้มันขึ้นไม่ได
้ทีนี้ที่บอกว่าตรงเนี้ยเก่าแก่มากเพราะว่า
ประมาณยุคก่อน 4,000 ปีก่อนประวัติศาสตร
์ว้าวRight now we are at the second spot of Patam National Park เรามาจุดที่2ของPatam เรียบร้อยแล้วนะฮะ
ตรงนี้จะเป็นจุดที่2ซึ่งเรียกว่าจุดPatam และก็คือชื่อจุดนี้ก็คือชื่อของอุทยานแห่งชาติ
ก็คือPatam คือชื่อของการแต้มตรงนี้นี่เอง
ซึ่งมันมีความชัดเจนตรงที่มันมีรูปภาพวาดมากมายอันนี้เป็นลักษณะของภาพวาด
Okay, so the name Patam, which I told you earlier that it means painting, actually derived from this spot.Because there's a lot of painting in here. There will be like the picture of the elephants there, the picture of the fish, and also the equipments that the people used to use when they want to go fishing. ก็คือมีอุปกรณ์เห็นการทำงานเห็นพวกเขาด้วย
I believe viewers are curious as I am at what kind of colors are used and how are they still intact for thousands of years.There are many theories given, whether it be the use of herbs as mixture. Some groups would say that it is a mixture of rocks. Up until now, it remains a phenomenon on how the drawings are still here after 4,000 years.
สันนิษฐานกันไปหลายอย่างบางคนก็บอกว่าทำจากสมุนไพรบางชนิดพวกใบไม้หรือรากไม้มาผสมกันเป็นสี
หรือ
บางคนก็บอกว่าจากหินที่เอามาผสมกันแต่มันมีความน่าทึ่งมากคือว่ามันอยู่มาเป็น 4,000 ปี
ใช่นานมากเลย
อันนี้คือความสุดยอดของผาแต้มของสีที่ใช้กัน
After having enjoyed with nature at Patam, there is yet another feature of Ubon Rajthani province, and that is the Thai Grand Canyon. If one were to travel far to see nature's miracle, such as the Grand Canyon, the land of cliffs and canyons in the state of Arizona, United States of America,which is considered a famous tourist attraction with tourists all around the world going to visit the place. Numbering over hundreds of thousands per year, this may be considered just a little bit too far. Today, we would like to introduce you to the Thai Grand Canyon, a tourist place that is very near, which I can guarantee that it will steal your breath away. That place is the Samphanbo, Grand Rocks on the Mekong River, which stretches out very long and extremely beautiful of this Ubon Rajthani province.
How does this place become like this?
คือสามพันโบนี่มันเป็นส่วนหนึ่งของนิเวศแม่น้ำโขง
ครับ
ซึ่งในช่วงฤดูน้ำนี่น้ำจะท่วมที่นี่ที่นี
่ถึงนี่เลยเหรอครับ
ถึงนี่เลยครับแล้วก็ไอ้แรงของน้ำกระแสน้ำก็ทำให้เกิดซอกเกิดหลุมเกิดอะไรมากมาย
This is a kind of the natural place where nobody do any construction here ไม่มีใครมาสร้างขึ้น Nobody construct here at all it's all natural andOn the normal, on the rainy period, on the day when the tide is very high, the water level is supposed to be around here. That means you can't even see any Grand Canyon in here at all. It will all covered by the water. น้ำก็จะคลุมท่วมหมดเลย
ใหญ่มหาศาลเดินวันเดียวไม่จบครับเดี๋ยวเราจะพาไปดูว่ามันอยู่ตรงไหนบ้างที่มันสวย
ๆ Viewers and this is the first sightseeing point What does it look like Yes it resembles Mickey Mouse
มันเกิดขึ้นได้ยังไงครับเนี่ยอันนี
้มันก็คือเหมือนมีโบก3โบกที่มันเชื่อมต่อกันแต่การเชื่อมต่อนี่มันเชื่อมต่อมีลักษณะที่มันดูแล้วเหมือนหน้าตาของมิกกี้เมาส์
คือเป็นความบังเอิญ
ใช่ครับเรียกว่านี่คือโบกมิกกี้เมาส
์ So it is an accident the three holes from this place connected to each other so it's become like the Mickey Mouse face like yep three of them happen to be hereby chance ก็คือบังเอิญเกิดขึ้นเอง3อันติดกันอย่างนี้นี่เอง
Besides this there are also many other boats that awaits us to use our imagination take this boat for instance I don't know whether I am in love or notBut at whatever angle I look at it, it resembles a heart.
เหมือนอะไรก็ได
้ครับ
อยู่ที่ว่าคนที่จะไปเจอ
จะจินตนาการได้อ๋อ
น
ั
่นมันจึงท้าทายให้มาค้นหาม
าค้นหา
And another feature of this place is the Emerald Pool, or what the villagers coin as Bung Nam Sai, or a clear water pond. It is a large natural pond situated on the Bok Cliff Rock.Approximately 3 meters deep, and no matter what season it is, there will always be an emerald green color throughout the year. The water is at its clearest point during December. What is even more a miracle is the fact that the water level in the bowl would always remain the same.
คือชาวบ้านเชื่อว่าเป็นน้ำศักดิ์สิทธิ์ที่มีประทานมาจากสิ่งศักดิ์สิทธิ์ที่อยู่บนสวงสวรรค
์อ
๋อทีนี้น้ำแถวนี้ชาวบ้านเขาจะไม่ลงไปอาบทำน้ำร่างกายเขาจะถือว่าเป็นน้ำศักดิ์สิทธิ์ที่ไว้บูชา
ครับ As a sacred place it is believed that the water is also holy so every season when every time when it's come to the dry period there will be also the ritual set up by the people in the communities they set up here they invite the monks and they perform the ritual here as to start the new season and there is also restriction that in this pond there will be no onewho will come down into the water, jump down in the water and play the water in this pond. Unlike the other ponds where we can enjoy. ก็คือจริงๆบ่ออื่นเนี่ย ลงไปได้ตามปกติยกเว้นบ่อนี้ so this is the only exception that we will not jump down and play the water inside the pond ครับ
We have arrived to the point where it is called the Thai Grand Canyon. During flooding times, we cannot be seated here like this. The flowing water will bring with it various Mekong fishes in large quantities, thus facilitating a distinctive feature for locals on the Mekong riverside of this Ubon Rajthani.Beyond the miracle that nature has created for Ubon Rajthani province, I will bring you to view the old lifestyle that is rich with the sense of Ubon Rajthani culture that is bonded with Mekong River. This is due to the fact that natural resources in this area are critical to the living nature of villages around here, and that is fishing. But for me,To suddenly bring our viewers to dive and catch fishes would not be prudent. I will bring our viewers to be introduced to various fishing equipment first, along with the location where stories of this place, history, and local living culture are collected, Thai Ban Museum.
ถ้าเป็นพื้นที่แถบนี้นะครับก็จะมีตุ้มครับคือตัวนี้
อันนี้เลยนะครับ
ใช่ครับ
เดี๋ยวขอยกมานี่นะฮะ
ได้ครับ
โอเค so I'll take this is the first kind of equipment and they call it ตุ้ม
ครับ
ตุ้มนี่คืออะไรครับเนี่ยตุ้มนี่เป็น
ไว้จับปลาในช่วงหน้าฝน
ตุ้ม is for do fishing during the rainy period
เวลาใส่เราก็จะเอาลงไปในแม่น้ำ
ใส่ลงไปอย่างนี้เลย
อย่างนี้เลยแล้วก็จะปูน้ำอยู่ประมาณนี้
so when we use it we drop this into the water just like this
ปลาได้กลิ่นก็จะเข้าจากด้านล่าง
ครับคือเราเอาเหยื่อใส่ไว้ตรงไหนฮะใส่ลงไปข้างใน
ใส่ลงไปข้างในเลย
so we put the prey inside here and then you know the fish which is below when they smell it they will come มันก็จะมาทางนี้
ปลาก็จะเข้าทางนี
้so they go in here
มีคล้ายๆเรียกว่างาตุ้มปลาเข้าได้แต่ออกไม่ได้
so there will be another thing here which they call
งา
this one when the fish goes in it will cannot come out
but for our viewers let me bring your attention to an equipment built by the locals know-how or locals wisdom that I have come to love specially and that is the lan that is equipped with a deviceWhich can catch fishes of 1 to 30 kilograms.
อันนี้หน้าตาเหมือนยังไงเอ่ย
มันจะเป็นคล้ายๆเป็นกับดักนิดหน่อยก็คือว่าจะมีเหยื่ออยู่ข้างใน
We have prey inside.
ปลาได้กินเหยื่อก็จะเข้าไป
Okay, so this one when the fish can smell the prey which is inside, the fish will just go in. And there is a net here, the green net ก็คือมีตะข่ายอยู่ใช่ไหมครับ
ใช่ครับ
When the fish hits the net.มันชนปุ๊บ
เสร็จแล้วก็มันก็จะตะข่ายนี่ก็จะไปกระตุกกับสลักที่ล็อกไว
้ครับ so there will be some mechanism behind which when the fish hit the nets and then it will close okay เรามาลองทำดูดีกว่า let's try so if we hit the nets อย่างนั้นถ้าเราไปชนตะข่ายนะครับสมมุติเราชนปุ๊บเรียบร้อย wow okay so it's closed so the fish will stuck inside ก็คือพอมันชนเรียบร้อยปุ๊บนี่ปิดปลาก็จะออกไม่ได
้ Know-how or wisdom of Thais is extraordinary. Look at this. We have brought bamboos that can be found in nature to build a fishing trap such as this one. We use rocks to draw down the weight in the closing trap when fish comes in.It could easily be said that money investment is unnecessary. I could hardly believe that in this Thai Ban Museum, that situated in a small house would have fully integrated knowledge and the grand way of life of folks along the Mekong River. Let me excuse myself to wheel around the museum first, because tomorrow morning, Pipai will have us go try our real fish catch, the real way of life in fishing like those along the Mekong River of Ubon Ratchathani. Moon River is an important river in the northeast region. The water source is from Nakhon Ratchasima province and joins with Mekong River at Amphoe Khong Chiem, this Ubon Ratchathani province. We will call this river estuary as Pak Moon. This place is rich with ecosystem resources. It is a place for food and a location for essential natural resources that is vital for the way of life of villagers and the community that lives around here, as Pak Moon community takes up fishing as their main occupation.
Need it. Okay, well, it's pretty amazing. I mean, I do not regret anymore, like I said before, like I shouldn't have promised to come this early, but wow, now I changed my mind. This is amazing. You know, you get onto the boat with like manually doing by all the people. It is handmade anyway. Yep, so we are already on the boat and then soon I'm going to fish a fish, like a real fish, which I have never done it before. I just can't explain how exciting it is. So we go a little bit further, like not that far. We're going a little bit further. So it's the location that is like really good for fishing. And then we'll start catching. And today our journey to do fishing is already finished. We have 3 fish, which is the size is like, I think it's even smaller than my palm. So you can see that the life of the people, the life of the villagers in this kind of community, that we see a lot of fishermen on their boat in the river. But actually it's not that easy, because some days they'll be able to catch a lot of fish for us to eat. Imagine we go into the restaurant, we enjoy big fish on the table. But then the people here, their life depends on a lot of things. The river flow, the luck, all the stuff make them tell them if they can catch or they cannot. Someday they don't even get any fish. So that's how they have to depend on a lot of factors, which are actually an important part of their life. So I would like to say thank you to Pipai for these couple days that we have been doing a lot of things. We have visited interesting places, tourist attractions, the place where tourists always come visiting. But apart from that, we also visit the villages, the community, the people, lifestyle. We see how it is, we realize how difficult it is by we actually doing it. We come down here, we do fishing, we realize how their life is difficult, how it depends on several factors, nature and all those stuff. So we see how it is in here. So I have to say thanks to Pipai and also his fellows. Khapun ma khap. But if you would like to see more stories about this, about a lot of cultures and history of Thailand, also visiting more tourist attractions, and here, since we are running out of time already and the sun is shining, so we have to say goodbye to you. Thank you for watching Thailand at Large, and we hope to see you again in our next episode.
สวัสดีครับ
you.